Hello beautiful people,
welcome to another Inno tutorial construction video.
In the previous video, we discussed about the Three Gorges Dam in China, which is the biggest dam in the world,
and the controversies about the Three Gorges Dam, which some people can argue by saying building the dam was just a waste of time, was a waste of money, and was a waste of resources, while others can also say building the dam was worth every penny. So because of this argument, this video is now going to try to answer the question. Is it even worth it to build a massive hydroelectricity dam? That is the question. Now before answering that question, let's first of all take a look at dams in general. Dams are some of the most impressive and well-noticed aspects of modern infrastructures. And throughout history, dams have played an important role in the growth and expansion of civilization. In fact, many ancient city planners back then used to rely on dams to alter the terrain which they plan to fight on. And also, because we know that flood waters can provide valuable nutrients to the soil and they can easily replenish water supplies, but if they are not properly controlled, then it becomes a problem. So as a result of this, a dam will be constructed to store the water and also to control the amount of water which is moving down a stream or a river. In 1935, when the US President Franklin Roosevelt opened the Hoover Dam, the Hoover Dam was the largest concrete structure on the planet at that time. In the following decades, we started seeing countries like India, Switzerland, Pakistan and Spain also constructing dams. So, in today's modern world, dams like the Hoover Dam or the Three Gorges Dam are used to create electricity or they are used to facilitate water for irrigation and to also prevent flooding. Now, because most things in the world are not only structures, we most times usually have advantages and disadvantages. So to answer the question if building a massive hydroelectric dam is worth it or not, let's see the advantages and disadvantages of building a dam. And you can decide if the advantages outweigh the disadvantages, then it might be worth building one. But if the disadvantages outweigh the advantages, then maybe it is really not that necessary to build one. And this can also be dependent on the reason why you want to build a dam in the first place. What problems are you trying to solve, and will there be any consequences while solving the problem and after solving the problem? Also, if there are indeed any consequences, then how do you minimize these consequences? We all need to take this into consideration before building a massive dam. Now, why most countries in the world love to build massive dams? It's because of its beneficial aspect, which is the potential to create hydroelectric power. Converting the potential energy of water into electrical energy is a relatively new concept. So this is one of the advantages most countries look at when creating a massive dam. Now, how does this massive dams create the hydroelectric power? That is the question. After a dam has been sited on a river, it usually creates a reservoir. To generate electricity using a hydro dam, you need two things: an abundance of water and an elevation difference between the outlet and the inlet side of the dam. The difference in elevation is referred to as the head. The head water is located upstream of the dam, while the tail water is located downstream of the dam. The dam separates the head water and the tail water. Water enters the penstock through the main inlet. The water then travels down the penstock to reach a hydroelectric turbine, which is located within the power house. As the water passes through each turbine runners, the runners rotate and convert the potential energy of the water into mechanical energy. Then the mechanical energy from the turbine runners is passed through an electric generator, So we have now converted the potential energy of the water into electrical energy. Now we can distribute this electrical energy to a transformer, then to a high voltage natural grid, which then give us electricity. And as you all know, hydroelectricity is one of the most studied forms of alternative energy because it is very reliable and stable. And also, most hydroelectric power plants have low maintenance and operational costs. And according to FEMA, hydroelectric power currently amounts 8 to 12% of current electricity need, and overall creates about 100,000 megawatts of electricity. Like we all know that flooding can be so disastrous for many homes and communities, and especially if the nearby water resources are hard to control. So because of this, most countries tend to build dams to redirect waterways to other safe areas in order to keep communities safe from flooding. And building a massive dam can also open up more land to build on because the river has been converted to reservoir, which creates open land. Now, because the presence of a dam creates a reservoir, which can be used as a great source of water, specifically for farm works or industrial activities. In fact, dams have been used for centuries for irrigation purposes. In Egypt, the Aswan High Dam gives local farmers protection against any harsh droughts and famines of the desert by controlling the water supply of the huge Nile River. Some dams also help to protect the environment by trapping hazardous materials in water and capturing sediment that could contain harmful or toxic substances. Some dams also have what we call mine tailing impoundments, and these help to facilitate the processing of minerals in an environmentally friendly way. So, these are some of the advantages some countries look at before deciding to construct a massive dam. And there are some other advantages, but these are the most commonly considered advantages. And I hope you already get to know some of the advantages. After a dam has been constructed, water rushes through the dam and its turbines, which can create a spot for sediment layers to be trapped. Therefore, it can pollute the water and also disrupt the ecology of the water environment, which becomes a major problem for the environment. Now, just like the first disadvantages, risk of sediment buildup, which becomes a problem for the environment. Rushing flood waters replenish the nutrients of the soil in water, which is beneficial to all plant and animal life in rivers and waterways. And when water is diverted due to a dam, it can greatly disrupt the delicate natural ecosystem. In fact, after the Aswan Dam in Egypt was built, there was a decline in fish production around areas because the amount of nutrients and food was less when compared to before the dam was built. So as you can see, it can have a damaging effect to the environment. After the construction of many dams, erosion of the surrounding soil is usually noticed. The large reservoir at the Tiri Gorges Dam has eroded nearby shoreline, which has led to landslide along the side of the reservoir. The Nile Delta has also experienced erosion due to the reduction of sediment after the construction of the Aswan High Dam. And much of the sediment has fallen into the reservoir, which means there is less land around to farm and work on. Most times, the cost of building a dam is just too astronomical. The engineering and technical aspects, along with the actual construction, is a time-intensive and a very laborious process, which means it takes too much time and effort to build a massive dam. Take like the Tiri-Gorges Dam, for example. This dam took almost 2 decades to complete. That is just too much of a time to complete a project. The Tiri-Gorges Dam was built in an area prone to seismic activities, and small cracks has already been found in the dam. Also, when a dam collapses or breaks down, this would be an absolute catastrophe, especially a dam as massive as the Tiri-Gorges Dam. So it is better not to collapse. In America, there was a time when a hurricane called Hurricane Harvey hit Texas. After that hurricane, dams in the Austin area were pushed to their limit by massive flood waters. And according to Texas observers, they worried that water could overflow from some of the dam spillways. And when this happened, they are scared it will be controlled, which will result to massive flooding. So, these are the advantages and disadvantages of building a massive dam. Now, what can we say after seeing these advantages and disadvantages? Is it still worth it to build a massive dam? Well, I would say, even though dams are a major part of modern infrastructures, their positives and negatives on societies and the environment are still being studied. And because most times, the way we plan things don't usually end up as planned, and I would say, if after building a massive dam, we end up taking more lives and property, then it is really not that necessary to build one, because the main purpose of building one in the first place is to cater for the need of the people. And if the properties and life has been lost, then who are we going to cater for? So that is the question. So why build one when properties and life has been lost? But if this is not the case, then I would say it is worth building one, because after all, the advantages it will provide for many people can't be overlooked, just the same way its disadvantages can't be overlooked as well. But if you have any other opinion as to if building a massive dam is worth it or not, then you can let us know by going to the comment section below this video and type your opinion. We would like to know if building a massive dam is worth it or not. If you leave a good comment in the comment section below, I'm going to pin your comment, meaning your comment is going to appear at the top. And also, before you leave, don't forget to subscribe to the channel Eno Tutorial. So if you are new to this channel, subscribe to the channel Eno Tutorial by clicking the red subscribe button to get updates on any civil engineering construction video. You can also share the video and the channel with friends, and don't forget to give the video a thumbs up if you enjoy the video. God bless you all.